everyone. I just wanted to make a very quick video on a product, RAVE. I've been really, really happy with the COVERFX line lately because I had recently had an allergic reaction to some skincare products that I was using. And as a result, my skin was going absolutely nuts. It was just so bad. And my cheeks were breaking out, my forehead was breaking out, my nose was breaking out, and my chin was just like cratery bumps. It was just yuck. So that probably explains a little bit about why I haven't been posting videos for a little while. And it also explains, I guess, why I've switched over from powder foundations, which I was using before, to some liquid foundations. So right now I am using Bare Minerals still occasionally, and I still really like it, but I've decided to switch over to trying out some liquid foundations because it's getting a little bit drier as well, because it's just fall and summer. I like to use powder foundations, but winter sometimes I alternate between powder and liquid. So right now is the COVERFX line Natural FX. This is a water-based foundation, and I really, really love this. I'm using M40 because my skin is still pretty dark right now, and I just really, really love this foundation. I'm so happy with it. It has great flexible coverage. It's very buildable, and the line is all mineral products. This one I don't believe is a mineral, actually, come to think of it, but I know that they're very famous for their mineral line. So I know COVERFX has multiple different variations of their minerals, so like the pressed powder, the loose powder, a matte, you know, setting powder and everything. So they have various mineral products. This one I don't believe is mineral, but it's water-based and it is good for your skin. It's recommended by a lot of cosmetologists as well. And it was actually originally advertised for very buildable coverage that helps cover birthmarks, scarring on your face, and all those things. I mean, fortunately for me, I don't have a lot of scarring or anything that I need to cover up significantly, but it's just such a good foundation. I really wanted to share it with you guys and to let everybody know that there is a great foundation you can pick up at Shoppers Drug Mart, and that it's very comparable to Sephora brands that I've tried. So this one is a water-based foundation, and it says it's advertised as leaving the skin feeling rehydrated and radiant, and the revolutionary Dermafix technology provides flexible coverage all day wear. So it's really great because it has SPF 15. I find that it's quite moisturizing even after I use my moisturizer. I like to sometimes have an extra kick of moisture because I've been getting dry skin around my nose and around my mouth. So this one has been really, really great to combat that. The SPF really is great because sometimes I forget to wear sunblock. I know I say in my everyday look I use sunblock moisturizer, but sometimes I'm in a rush and I'll just grab whatever moisturizer is on my desk sometimes, and because of that, I know that this will always leave me protected anyway, so it's nice to have this as a go-to. But I don't use very much product either, so that's something really, really great to have, is that I like the coverage of it even when I apply it just with my fingertips. And I believe this one, they recommend you either use a sponge or use your fingers. And I like the consistency I get from just using my fingertips. I don't apply very much product. I probably apply just about this much of my fingertips. So maybe just like the top part, about this much of product. And then I'll dab a little bit on both the center of my cheek, one in the center of my nose, one on my forehead, and one down here. And then I just take my fingertips. I usually just wash my hands and use my both hands. Dab it all over my face like this. Spread it in, and then I just let it kind of, and until it smooths into all the spots, and then I dust it over with a little bit of, you know, HD powder from Makeup Forever, which I think is a great staple product to have as a setting powder. I use this, and a kabuki brush, which I can't find right now. It's the HD Ultra Definition powder. And I also really like this one. I've been alternating with this one as well. It's by IT Cosmetics by Jamie Kern. And this one you can actually find on the shopping channel. And this was actually a gift from them to me. And I really, really like it as a setting powder. I find it very comparable to this one, to the Makeup Forever setting powder. And it's both white, translucent setting powder. But I find that depending on the finish I want, sometimes if I want it to be a little bit more matte, I'll use this one versus the Makeup Forever one. I find that the IT Cosmetics one is great for setting a really long all day look, and I think that the texture of it is a little bit thicker than this one right here, than the Makeup Forever. And because of that, I believe it's because this one is actually, it feels more, what's the word, kind of like a little bit drier in texture than this one. So it depends on the type of look I want and the type of finish I want. So if I want a matter look after I use something like a more radiant, dewy foundation, then I'll use the IT powder. And on the days that I want something just a little bit less matte, I'll go for this Makeup Forever. So lately I've been kind of going for a glowing look, so I've been using the Makeup Forever powder. And I then follow it up after using this foundation and everything. And after setting it, I just use a tiny, tiny bit of concealer. I dab it around here, just pat it in again, and that's it. Then I'm done. I don't actually set the concealer over top, which is, I know, probably not the best idea, but it just kind of what I do because I want to make sure that I got all the spots covered. And because I do wear sunglasses on my drive to work and everything, I notice that they still always turn red. So I'm kind of, from time to time, I'm repowdering around my nose anyway. So it doesn't really bother to me too much to apply a little bit of concealer where I still notice visible redness. And this one is the ConcealFX that I'm using, and it's in the light medium. And I really, really like this because it's great for camouflaging any dark spots around your eyes. It's great with concealing pimples. And once again, it has this great hygienic spout tip, very similar to how they have the same on their foundation. And I just love this line. Just, you know, it's a great high quality product. The price point's not awful. It's about, this one was about $30, this one was about $40, so it will last me forever. I haven't made a dent in it at all, and I've been using it pretty much every day for the past, like, month and a bit. And I just love how, on my bad skin days, I just apply a little bit more, and it doesn't make me look cakey or anything, there's no glitter to it, and the color matches me dead on. So I just have to rave about this CoverFX line, and I'm very happy about it. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to let me know. And I am still trying other foundations, so I will say that even though I just love this product, I'm always on the hunt for the next product for me to test out. And I'm sure you guys already watched my last video that I've already spoken about the Nars foundation. So I do admit that I like to keep things fresh and keep trying new products, but this one is just a great go-to staple of liquid foundation that I'll definitely have in my case. And that's it. So thanks so much for checking out this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I can't wait to hear what you guys think about your favorite foundations. Thanks.